Welcome. The focus today is on learning how to use the VNC Viewer object in EasyBuilder Pro to remotely control another device. Before beginning, ensure devices run the correct OS version required for different models. In this example, a CMT3092X will connect to a CMT2078X VNC server. Let's get started. Open EasyBuilder Pro. Select CMT3092XV2 from the list, and click OK to create a new project. To add a VNC viewer, navigate to the toolbar, select Object, then Media, and choose VNC Viewer from the drop-down menu. In the General tab, enter the IP address and port number of the VNC server. For this demonstration, use the IP address 192.168.2.26 and port number 5900 for setup. Check the default password option and enter a password in the password field. This setup facilitates automatic login for the VNC viewer. Select the color level, such as low 256 colors, to maintain a stable connection. Enable the title bar by selecting the title bar option. With the CMT2078X resolution at 800 by 480 pixels, adjust the VNC viewer object height to 504 pixels to accommodate the title bar. This adjustment ensures the entire screen, including the title bar, fits correctly, as scaling is not supported in VNC viewer. Now, proceed to download the project to the HMI for execution. As the VNC viewer only supports HMI execution without PC simulation, downloading to the HMI is necessary for viewing and adjusting the results. Observe as the VNC viewer automatically initiates connection with the VNC server on the CMT2078X using the default password. Next, configure the VNC viewer with a control address. Assign LW0 as the control address. Displayed are control addresses for parameters such as status, command, IP, port, default password, password, title bar, and title bar name. Enable the Enable Runtime Modification in Control Function option within the General tab. This setup allows adjustments to color levels during runtime. To enhance the configuration of VNC viewer settings during runtime, add relevant objects to the screen. Start by adding a text object to label status. Follow up with a numeric object for status and link it to control address LW0. Add a text object to label command. Then, include a numeric object for command and link it to control address LW1. Add a text object to label IP. Then, add a numeric object for IP and link it to control address LW2. Use the multiple copy function to create four numeric objects for the IP address. This automatically generates objects for LW2, LW3, LW4, and LW5. Add a text object to label port. Then, add a numeric object for port and link it to control address LW6. Add a text object to label password. Follow this up with an ASCII object for password, linking it to control address LW8. Note that the password length is 16 words. Add a text object to label color level. Then, add a numeric object for color level and link it to control address LW41. Download the project again to the HMI for further adjustments. As noted earlier, since the VNC viewer does not support simulation, the results must be viewed and adjusted directly on the HMI. The control addresses and objects are set for runtime configuration, allowing manual start and configuration of the VNC connection with these controls. Once the project is operational on the CMT3092X, observe the initial values set for each parameter. Adjust settings to fit specific needs. Begin by setting the command to 1 to initiate the connection to the VNC server. Adjust the color level for enhanced image quality by setting color level to 3, corresponding to full all available colors. After adjusting the color level, update connection parameters by setting the command to 3. Observe the improved image quality. This concludes the demonstration. Thank you for watching and participating.